Is the screen visible? Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in the last class, we have discussed about a few definitions, fundamental definitions. There are a few more left to be discussed. Today, we'll continue with the basic definitions. And at the end of this class, at 11:45, 12:45, you will be getting access to a quiz, 5-question quiz. You have to answer that, okay? You will get it automatically at 11:45. It will be activated. So you will get an invitation through your mail, and you should submit it before 12:55. Okay, you have got 10 minutes and 5 questions based on the things what we discussed in the previous 2 classes. Okay. So now, in the previous class, we discussed about, I think, about loop and mesh. Okay, so loop and mesh were the last things what we discussed in the previous class. Okay, today we will be looking into few more definitions. So next is linear circuit. Okay. Next definition we would like to see is linear circuit. Just a moment, what has happened? Okay. We know the word linear. Linear generally we use for proportion or proportional. When I want to plot a graph between any two parameters, between x and say y, okay, if I get a straight line passing through origin, okay, that we call it as linearity. Okay, that we call it as linearity. So what does this graph indicates here is, as I am varying the value of x, there is variation in the value of y. Okay, so generally we keep our input at on x axis and output on y axis. This generally we do. Okay, so linearity means if there is a proportional change in output with respect to proportional change in input. So that is simple definition of linearity, okay, or understanding of linearity. Now what a linear circuit means is, okay, the circuit that follows superposition principle. Okay. The circuit that follow that follows superposition principle. We'll see what is superposition principle. Okay. Superposition principle. You have studied in physics previously that superposition of two waves or two signals, okay, that is the adding of one wave on the other wave, okay, or one wave having its effect on the other wave, which will be resulting on some other wave. Okay, this the name superposition you already have heard about this. Okay. Now, what superposition here means is, suppose I have a circuit. I have a circuit here, whatever may be the circuit. Okay. And to this, I will be giving some, say for example, input. Let this be V of t. And I get some output, say C of t. Of t indicates with respect to time. Okay, so whenever I write the system characteristics, I write it with respect to time. Okay, and in definition of linearity, the time also matters. Okay, why and how I will tell you after a moment. Now, this circuit is giving some output C of t when the input given is say V of t. Now, if I multiply this input say by k times, if I multiply the input by k times, say suppose I am giving 2 volts to the circuit and I am getting some 2 amps in the circuit. Okay, say that circuit, let me take it as a resistor. Okay, so now here I will apply, so it is 1 ohm, the input is say 2 volts and output is say I is equals to 2 amps. Now what I will do, I will multiply a scalar quantity to a input, I will multiply some k times the input, then if my output is also multiplied by k times, then we say this circuit to be linear. Okay, if there is proportional change in input when there is change proportional change in output when there is change in input, then that circuit is called linear circuit. Okay, so this is simple understanding. Then what is superposition principle means is, now suppose I am applying a set of inputs to the system. Now I have a system or a circuit here. Okay, to this I am applying a set of inputs, let it be V1 of t plus V2 of t. And if I get output as C1 of t plus C2 of t, this is linearity. Okay, this is linearity. Okay, so if V1 of t produce output C1 of t and V2 of t produce output C2 of t, then V1 of t plus V2 of t produce output C1 of t plus C2 of t. So let this be circuit. Okay. Now if I multiply some scalars to V1 of t and V2 of t. Okay. Now if it is such that V1 of t produce output C1 of t. Okay. V2 of t produce output C2 of t. Okay. Now if K1 V1 of t plus K2 V2 of t produce output. Okay, it is not equal to, it is producing the output. If this produce output, K1 C1 of t plus K2 C2 of t. So this is called principle of superposition. Principle of superposition. In the sense, what we are talking here is, if I have a weighted sum of inputs producing weighted sum of outputs, then that is called the principle of superposition. That is called the principle of superposition. Okay. If the superposition principle is satisfied by any circuit, that circuit automatically becomes linear. So for example, I have this circuit. Now I will multiply this 2 volts by say 2 into 2 volts will give 2 into 2 amps. So if I provide 4 volts input, I get 4 amps output. So this circuit is linear. Resistance is linear. Now, what I will do to the same circuit, I have a 1 ohm resistor. Okay. I will add 2 batteries. This is for our understanding. Okay, need not be the same every time. Now I will give 2 into 2 volts, 3 into 3 volts. This is 1 ohms. Now what will be the current? I is equals to, depending upon the value of resistor. Okay, it need not be that C1 of t is equal to C2 of t. Okay, it can be anything. I have taken 1 ohms to just for our normalized understanding. So current I will be equals to 2 into 2 volts, 2 into 2 volts divided by 1 plus or plus 3 into 3 volts divided by 1. So the grand input is 4 volts plus 9 volts, that is 13 volts. The grand output is I. If I take current as output, I is equals to 13 amps. Okay. So here, the output is the weighted sum of input. If this principle is followed, that is called principle of superposition. Okay. This is called principle of superposition. If the principle of superposition is followed, then the circuit is linear. Now, what is non-linear circuit? Reverse of this. So, non-linear circuit means is the circuit that does not follow superposition principle. Simple. Circuit that does not follow superposition principle. So in the sense, if you take a circuit my V of t producing a output C of t, okay, here K into V of t will not produce K into C of t. The best example is a diode. Okay, if you apply some voltage to diode, okay, now to this, when you apply the voltage, and if you forward voltage only, V, if you plot the characteristics of diode, this is I, D, diode current, VF, forward voltage. Okay, then the characteristic of diode will be exponential, because if you see the fundamental equation for diode, ID is equals to I naught into e to the power eta vt by some term, okay, or very very generally, if I want to tell, e to the power some x can be anything depending upon the operating condition of the diode. Fundamentally, it is an exponential relation, and exponential relation cannot be a linear relation. So any circuit that does not follow superposition principle, it won't be a linear circuit. Now, if I increase the voltage, okay, up to say Vt threshold value, there is no effect in the current. Even if I change from 0 to 0.5 volts for a silicon, there is no effect on the current. Okay, and the moment threshold voltage is crossed, A very small amount of voltage is sufficient to create a large amount of current in the diode. Hence, the amount of current and the amount of voltage applied are not linearly related, but are exponentially related. Okay, so such circuits are called non-linear circuits. So circuits that do not follow superposition principle are called non-linear circuits. Okay. Next, bilateral circuit. Okay, next point is bilateral circuit. Bilateral circuit. Okay. So bilateral circuit is what? If the response of the circuit is identical, irrespective of the direction of current in it, is called bilateral circuit. Okay. If the response of circuit is identical, okay, with both the direction of current, or instead of with both identical, independent of direction of current, in it, independent of direction of current in it. Okay, so if any circuit is responding same irrespective of the direction of current in it, is a bilateral circuit. The very best example is resistive circuit. Okay, now suppose this is a resistor with a terminals AB. Through this, suppose a 1 ampere current is flowing, and say it is of say 5 ohm value, then what is VAB? Yes, it is 5 volts. Let us not worry about the direction. It is 5 volts. Okay. Now, if in the same circuit, if I simply reverse the direction of current, okay, if I simply reverse the direction of current, then VAB will be, say in case, minus 5 volts. Minus indicates only the direction. It has nothing to do with magnitude. So the amount of voltage present, okay, magnitude of VAB is still equals to 5 volts. So the amount of voltage present across a resistor depends upon the value of resistor and the current through it, irrespective of the direction of the current through it. Okay. So therefore, this is called a bilateral circuit. This is called a bilateral circuit. In this case, the inductor is also a bilateral component, or inductive circuit is also bilateral circuit. Capacitive circuit is also bilateral circuit. But a circuit that contains diodes and transistors are not bilateral circuits. Okay. If I take a diode, now to this, if I apply say 5 volts, or let this be A and B. Now, if I apply 5 volts to a diode, say specifically a silicon diode, then what is VAB? Yes, anybody? What is VAB?
0.7.
Yes?
0.7.
Yes. When the diode is forward biased, the maximum voltage across it is only the threshold potential or barrier potential. So VAB is 0.7 volts. Now, if I apply the reverse voltage, if I reverse the direction of the battery, VAB, now I will simply do do this and I apply 5 volts. Now what is VAB? Yes? Anybody? What is VAB? Samiksha is there? 19E048. Samiksha? Prashant R?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is VAB, Prashant?
5 volts.
Yes, it will be minus 5 volt in that case. Okay, because I have reversed the direction, it is minus 5 volts. So when I reverse the direction of the potential difference, the value of voltage is different. But whereas here the value of voltage is same, therefore a resistive, inductive, capacitive circuit is a bilateral circuit, whereas the circuit that contains diode, transistors, triacs, power electronic devices are unilateral circuits. Okay, so the next part is unilateral circuit. Okay? That is same, where the response of the circuit is not identical irrespective of the direction of current. Okay, next is unilateral. I won't define it, you please go through. Unilateral circuit. Okay, the response of circuit depends upon the direction of current. Okay, or I will write a statement. Response of circuit depends on direction of current. Okay. Next type of circuit or next definition is active circuit. Active circuit. Okay, so active circuit is one which contains active components. Okay, a circuit that contains at least one active component or one active element in it. A circuit that contains at least one active element in it is called active circuit. Then first we should know what is active element, is it? Active element is now you can visualize it as a source. Okay, active element is nothing but a source. If any circuit contains at least one source in it, that we call it as active circuit. Okay, so far any circuits what we have seen in earlier classes, all the circuits were active circuits because there was a voltage source or a current source. Okay, so without any source there can't be current or voltage in any circuit. So there must be at least one active circuit in a main circuit, at least one active element in the main circuit to do certain work. Why I am calling main circuit? Because when I see inactive or passive circuit, I will tell you what do you mean by main circuit and what do you mean by other sub circuit or dependent circuit. Okay, so active circuit is one which is having at least one active element or a source. Now source can be a current or voltage. It can be voltage or current source. In detail, we will be dealing with voltage and current sources in the coming classes. Right now, you just remember current or voltage source. Okay, that circuit is called active circuit. And then passive circuit. Passive circuit is a bit interesting than active circuit. So passive circuit, a circuit that does not contain any active element in it. Simple. Opposite of active circuit. A circuit that does not contain any active element in it. Then will there be a circuit like passive circuit? Just now I told that without the active sources, work done is unimaginable. Okay. Now if I would like to draw the active circuit, it can be anything. Or say for example, I would like to draw a circuit. Here only I will draw. Now let this be a voltage source. Let this be R1 and R2. Now we can imagine active circuits very well. Because if I want a current to be flown in the circuit, I need some EMF source there. Now here passive circuit will be of this sort. Say for example, now this is a passive circuit. What is the use of this passive circuit now? Work cannot be done in this circuit in any way. Work cannot be done in this circuit in any way. But we should remember that passive circuit doesn't hold only resistors. A passive circuit can contain a energy storage components or energy storage elements that can dissipate the energy. Okay, no doubt with respect to the basic definition of passive circuit, the circuit does not hold any kind of active element in it. Now for example, I will have a circuit that has capacitance in it. Okay, now let me assume this capacitor is charged to a voltage value Vc. Okay, this capacitor is charged initially to a voltage value Vc. And there is a resistor R, okay, load resistor RL. Now this will form a closed path. There is all possibility that this capacitor can discharge through this RL to ground. Is it possible? Yes? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Is it quite possible? Now let me take out this resistor. It may not, it should not create the confusion. Okay, now I have this circuit. Now it is quite possible that the capacitor which is charged initially can discharge through this RL to ground. Now discharging means what? Capacitor is giving out some current, ICD. I will call it as capacitor discharge current. Now without any active source in the circuit is still carrying current, still having some potential difference in it. And this circuit is consisting of all passive devices. Capacitor is also a passive device, resistor is also a passive element, resistor is also a passive element. Okay, so a passive circuit not all the time means that it is not doing work. A passive circuit may have, okay, passive circuit may have have energy storage elements and these can gain or dissipate or not dissipate, more specifically discharge. Energy. This is one example. The very common example of passive circuit, secondary of a transformer. Do you agree? Secondary of a transformer?
Yes, sir.
Now I have a transformer here to this primary. I connect the source. Say, for example, this is 230 volts. I am connecting. I have a secondary of transformer. To this, I am connecting a load. Okay. Now, if this is 1:1 transformer, I will get 230 volts here. Okay. Of load resistance, say RL is equals to 10 ohms. Now, what is the current flowing here? 230 bar 10 is equals to 23 amperes. A simple calculation. Let me keep it very simple. So if I observe only the secondary part of the transformer, only the secondary part of the transformer, it is a passive circuit. So only I told. In active circuit is one which is having at least one source in the main circuit. Now, if I don't connect 230 volts to the primary in the transformer, I don't get any secondary voltage in it. Likewise, if there was no priorly charged capacitor, this capacitor which may be connected to a source before connecting it to this resistance RL, there might have been some source which charged this capacitor. Capacitor cannot be charged automatically. There can be some source, either through direct connection or through electrostatic discharge or through electrostatic interference, whatever may be the reason. But there might be some source which has charged this capacitor earlier. Okay, then it will discharge its energy. So passive circuits are also useful in our circuit system or in our system where they can gain or discharge energy. Okay, where they can gain or discharge them. Best example is secondary of the transformer. Very best example for passive circuit. Okay, which does not have any active source in it or active element in it, where everything is passive. If I take a load resistance of RL resistance only, then it is an inductance connected to a resistance. Both are purely passive elements. Okay, but the ability of having the energy storage, the ability of energy storage of certain elements make them momentarily active. So when this has gained some energy and it is discharging, now it is acting like a battery or EMF source. So momentarily it is called an active device, but still it is passive in nature. Okay. So that is one circuit. Then another type of circuit is time invariant circuit, which is important. Okay. Another definition, we can say time invariant circuit. Now, what do you mean by time invariance? Vishaka? Vishaka, I thought.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what do you mean by time invariance?
Yeah.
Are you there?
Yes, sir. Time.
What do you mean by time invariance? Time invariant circuit I have written. What do you mean by that? A general understanding of yours. What do you understand by time invariant? There is no variation.
Yes, sir.
In what? Sahana? Sahana, are you there?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Can you tell what is time invariant mean? You just understand the name.
Maybe there is no variance in the time.
No variance in the time.
Like if some input.
How can time be stagnant? Time is continuously varying, is it?
Yeah.
Now it is how much exactly? 12:39 p.m. After 1 minute, it will be 12:40 p.m. of today's date. It is time is continuously varying. Time cannot be a constant. Have you come across this term, time invariance?
Sir, the values in a circuit does not change with time.
Yes, the values in the circuit does not change with time. Now, if I take alternating voltage, are the values not changing? Here it is zero, here it is maximum, here it is zero, here it is maximum, negative maximum, here it is some value in between maximum and zero. Here is somewhere up, we have shown V of t. It means voltage is varying with respect to time. Yeah, this is the common misunderstanding of time invariance. I purposely ask this because everybody thinks that the output of the circuit or the parameters of the circuit will not change with time. Now, if I take an alternating voltage and alternating current, definitely they will change with time over a period. Is it? So it is not the circuit parameters, those are changing with time. It is the circuit behavior that is not changing with time. Time invariance means what? Response of the circuit does not depend upon the time or does not change with respect to time. Okay. The circuit behavior, it is not exactly the circuit output. Okay. By the definition, it is written that the response of circuit does not change with time. Okay. Not with the time, with the time variations. Time variations. So what does it exactly mean? Time invariance understanding is important for especially electrical and electronic engineers, because every hardware system is most of the hardware systems we design for time invariance only. Okay, so very simple example what I can give you now is, suppose I have a resistor. This may be some circuit. Okay, I have one more resistor connected in parallel. Now suppose this is the resistance of a lamp, say 2 ohms. This is the resistance of a fan or impedance of a fan, say 3 ohms. And this is the resistance of some motor, say 5 ohms. Okay. Now every morning I want to turn on all three for some particular amount of time. So today I want to turn on my lamp and fan. Okay, it is very hot day, and motor also to pump the water from sump to overhead tank. And here I apply 230 volts. Okay, here I apply 230 volts, which is AC. What is the current drawn from the source now? I is equals to 230 divided by R equivalent, is it? So what is R equivalent? 1 over R equivalent is equals to 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 5. So 0.5 plus 0.33 plus 0.2. Is it? How much it will come? 1.033. Okay. This one. This is 1 over R equivalent. What is R equivalent? Somewhere near to 1 only. Is it? 0.999 something ohms. Okay. Whatever may be the value. Point 968, 0.97 you are getting. 0.97 ohms. Now what is the current drawn today morning when I turned on all three lamps, all three lamp, fan and motor? It is I is equals to 230 divided by 0.97, which is nearly equals to 231, 232 only. Okay. It won't be 237.6. It won't be this high. Okay, don't worry. I am just giving an example. Now what I will do, after 1 hour of today morning, I will turn off everything, and after 3 hours, I will turn on all three again. Will the current change? So morning from 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock, I will turn on all three, applying 230 volts. I get current of 237.6 amperes. Now again, evening at 6 to 9, I will do the same thing. Turn on all lamp, fan and motor. What will be the current run then?
Same,
obviously, is it? And if you observe this current is alternating. Is it not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Because voltage is alternating. I am applying 230 volt AC. So see, the output of the circuit is current. The current is changing with time. Okay, but the circuit is not changing its behavior with time. The response of the circuit is same at every point of time. This is called time invariance. The behavior of the circuit, if it doesn't change, then that property is known as time invariant property or time invariance of that particular circuit. The best example is one more take. You take a voltmeter. This is a very simple example I used to give every time. Okay. Because time invariance comes in where in many aspects. Now I have a voltmeter which can read from 0 to 100 volts. And today I will apply 10 volts. What will be the voltmeter showing? 10 volts? Yes or no? If voltmeter is proper, it shows 10 volts. Okay. Tomorrow I will go and observe and apply 10 volts. Tomorrow also it will show 10 volts. Tomorrow also it will show 10 volts. Okay. This property is known as time invariant property. Okay. This property is known as time invariant property. Okay. So these are the few definitions which we are repetitively using in our course. Okay, and these definitions will be useful for you if you remember it forever, because there are various definitions we get. Okay, various some derivatives.